At Cape Kennedy, the twice-postponed Gemini 9 space mission is ready to try for a third time. Weather conditions are perfect and the world waits. Astronauts Tom Stafford and Gene Cernan are suited up, ready to go. Stafford has had one trip in space already, but it's a first-time journey for Cernan. The ambitious space project is scheduled to include docking maneuvers, a spacewalk, and other experiments. There's even time for a joke with a giant match, an obvious sign of a relaxed, confident pre-flight mood. Both Cernan and Stafford clamber into their individual form-fitting chairs as launch time draws near. This tiny spacecraft, using every available interior inch for equipment and supplies, will be their space home for the next 3 days. Twice before they've come this far, only to have the mission scrubbed. The hatches are carefully closed and sealed, and both astronauts make themselves comfortable before the moment of launch. Ignition! And a perfect liftoff. As the Gemini Titan rocket pushes skyward with that familiar roar signaling another step into space for America, Mission Control announces a perfect trajectory as GT-9 speeds toward orbit. 3 days later, the pickup ship, the carrier Wasp, steams into position to recover the space capsule, which came down just 4 miles off her bow, the most accurate on-target splashdown ever. Signs proclaim a hearty welcome for the twin pioneers, who completed 72 hours, 21 minutes in space, a 3-day journey 45 times around the world. A happy ending to a mission that's been plagued with trouble since February. Stafford and Cernan arrived on the deck of the Wasp 51 minutes after splashdown. Frogmen reached the capsule so quickly, it was still hot from re-entry. NASA officials pronounced the Gemini mission an outstanding success, which produced guidelines for future man-in-space journeys.